everybody. I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today we're gonna be reacting to a long time YouTube favorite and honestly the most requested video people have been asking me to react to for years, and probably one of the most reacted to videos here on YouTube. And that is classically Abby's modesty video, okay? And the real name of the video is Hold Up, because I'm sure a lot of you guys have already watched it. Why you should dress modestly, get the attention you deserve. Now, honestly, I actually wanted to do a whole video on modesty culture because I think it's genuinely toxic, but I'm gonna do this reaction and probably give my little, you know, advice, tips, and annoyances here and there. But I think I might have to do a dedicated video. We'll just see how this one goes. But comment down below, what do you guys think about modesty culture? Honestly, my main issue with it is that it's usually always geared towards girls and never towards men, and I just do not like that. I feel like it's very misogynistic and honestly very detrimental to girls and their development. I feel like a lot of girls who grow up in this type of culture end up being very sheltered and end up being damaged in the end of all of this, and a lot of men usually have the upper hand. That's just my opinion. Comment down below what you think, and if you grew up in a family or in an environment that kind of pushed this type of ideology, because I would love to know how that went for you, because I really think that it's like really problematic. So let's get into this reaction. Of course, make sure you guys smash that subscribe button, smash that like button, smash everybody you know that can help a sister out. Make sure you guys get your merchandise. Everything is down in the description box down below. Join the D Mafia email list to get me notified every single time I post a video on a weekly basis. Join the D Mafia Discord, and yeah, just peep the description box, because you guys always ask me questions, and a lot of questions could be answered by looking in the description box. So let us get into this reaction. It's gonna be entertaining because people hate this video, y'all. 157,000 dislikes and 24,000 likes. Classically Abby is classically hated, I'll tell y'all that much. And I don't know. So bad about this.
Hello, beautiful ladies, and welcome to today's video, where we're going to be talking about modesty, why it's important, and why it doesn't mean looking like garbage.
I don't know. It was just so like in your face. That's how your video is supposed to be, in your face, to the point. Okay, but the aesthetic, oh my god, it's so nice. The background, the makeup, the lighting, so pretty.
Modesty is dressing in a way that doesn't sexualize your body. I get the appeal of not wanting to dress modestly all the time. Even for those of us who do dress modestly, sometimes it's hard. It's fun to dress in a way that makes you desirable. It's fun to be noticed. But the question is, who do you want to be desirable to?
It's fun to dress the way I want to, period. Everything she just said was very toxic. So the whole connotation here is people who don't dress modestly want to be noticed. That's literally the conclusion that I'm drawing from the statement that she just made. And that in itself is toxic. A lot of people who follow this modesty type of concept are the type of people who believe that people who lead the lifestyles outside of modesty want attention from men, want attention from, you know, the opposite sex or whatever the case may be. And that's why they wear short skirts, they wear their boobs out, or whatever the case may be. And that could not be further from the truth. A lot of times people just want to express themselves with the clothing that they wear. If they feel like wearing shorts, they want to wear shorts because maybe it goes with the new purse that they have, maybe it goes with this cute shirt that they got, maybe it goes with their shoes. I do believe that sometimes certain things can be very excessive. Like personally, I'm not gonna have my titties and my ass out at the same time. Like very rarely would I do something like that. If I have my titties out, I'm gonna probably wear some long pants. If I have my booty out, I'm gonna probably wear, like, you know, a covered shirt. I feel like both is too excessive, but even at that, some people really just like having everything out, and I feel like that's not that big of a problem. The problem here would be that a lot of people do kind of draw the two together. They're like, okay, well, that girl wants attention, that person wants, you know, people to notice her, that's why she's dressed like that. And then in men's perspective, they see a girl dressed a certain type of way, their first inclination is, oh,
she's a slut. Oh, she's a whore. Oh, you know, she must be easy because she's dressed like that. And that's how you get all of these situations of, you know, assault and, you know, all these things that I'm not going to talk about because I want my monetization. But the thing is, of course, that's not how men should think. And I'm not saying it's okay, but that is literally how a lot of men think. And as much as you want to wear what you want to wear, you can do that. But if you're going to wear that, make sure you're with other people because you're literally going to be a target. Should it be like that? No. But understand if you do that, especially if you do it on a consistent basis, people are going to start looking at you a certain way. And I really wish it was not like that. And honestly, the real answer and the real solution to this problem is people should raise their sons better. Instead of pushing this whole situation on woman and telling woman to dress better, saying woman needs to dress modestly, the situation needs to be raise your sons better. I'm actually working on a video called Maybe You Should Raise Your Sons Better, because this is a problem. Men should be raised to not put hands on women that are not interested in them, that they are not dating, whom they do not know, just because she's dressed a certain way, or feel like she is easy, or feel like he should have some sort of access to her because she dresses a certain way.
Do you want to be noticed for being beautiful or being sexy? Modesty is about treating your body with respect. It's about recognizing reality, that men are visual creatures, not emotional ones. It's about leaving things to the imagination. It's about dressing beautifully and attractively, but not garishly. It's about embracing femininity. And it's about dressing in public in a way that's appropriate for everyone, from children to grandparents to moms and dads. Modesty is a way for you to respect yourself and respect others. When you go to the park and you're surrounded by families with children, is it fair to dress in a way that's distracting? No.
An adult man and adult woman should know better than to be looking at your ass and your titties. As far as children, they don't give a fuck about any of that. The real problem here is, I guess, adolescent to grown ass men who are single, right? The real problem is, again, people need to raise their sons better. If you're listening to this and you're younger, it sounds so okay and it sounds so positive and you wouldn't see a problem with this message. But someone who's older and someone who's more experienced and someone who's kind of like lived life is just looking at this as like, what the fuck is this bitch talking about? This is what you call toxic positivity. There's another name for this, but it just ain't good. Like, it's not right. It really isn't. Everything she's saying isn't wrong though, in terms of men are visual and yeah, you should probably be appropriate in your children and stuff like that. I think a lot of this is pure common sense, right? Like, I know I wouldn't dress a certain way in front of children or dress a certain way in front of older people, but it's just so interesting because the way this is phrased is like, oh my Lord, like, oh, I pray for the younger generation.
Instead, dress in a way that's appropriate for the occasion. When you meet a guy and immediately have a connection, you have one chance to make an impression. Do you want him to leave having your body at the forefront of his mind, or you as a person? If you are wearing something incredibly revealing, it will be difficult for him to focus on your personality. Instead, he might be focusing on your physical appeal. Of course, there are men who will look at you this way no matter what. But more men will think of you as a sex object if you dress like one than if you dress like a lady.
This is so weird because she's right. She's kind of right to an extent, right? Now, you don't want to show up to a date literally dressed like you're going to church. But at the same time, yeah, if you do show up on a date literally looking like you about to do an OnlyFans, that's not a good first impression. But you also don't want to look frumpy. But at the same time, what's more important is not only your personality, but what you do on that first date. Like, if you're literally about to let a man pipe on the first date, that's kind of more important than what you're wearing, to be quite honest with you. So I guess this is accurate, but not. But it is, but it's not.
You should look attractive, but if you're dressing immodestly, you're not leaving anything to his imagination, and you're not giving him an opportunity to get to know you. I'm guessing you don't want to attract the kind of man who is only looking to spend one night with you. But when you dress immodestly, men are wired to have one thing on the brain. When you go to a work meeting, do you want to have cleavage and legs showing? No. You want the people there to listen to you and engage with your ideas, not your sexuality.
First of all, men and professional settings are two different things. So here's the thing. Sex is not everything, especially when it comes to men. This is why they can just fucking suck everything and not give a fuck about you. This is why they can have sex with you today and literally not text you for months and not give a fuck. Sex is not everything to men, and that's something that women need to get through their minds. Men care more about relationships, marriage, and children. Women care more about sex. But for whatever reason, women tend to think the other way around. This is why every time we going on dates and all of this goofy shit, we're sitting here like, oh, I'm not gonna fuck on the first date. I'm not gonna da-da-da-da-da-da-da. It don't really fucking matter. You could probably fuck a nigga on the first date and it really won't matter. Sometimes, I'm not telling y'all to do that. I'm just telling you this right now. I'm not telling y'all to do that, but I'm saying a lot of men literally can have sex with any and everyone and it doesn't really matter. But at the same time, you don't wanna sit there and just mess with a dude that quick because it may send the wrong message. It really just depends on the type of dude, where he's at in life, and how he sees you. A lot of it has to do with who you are. Because if you are someone with a trash personality, as horrible as it is, men are vain as fuck, okay? If you're not that attractive, you don't have a good personality, you don't dress well, I'm not even talking about like modesty, I'm talking about like you have no style, and then like say, you know, you don't have much going for yourself, and I'm not even talking about money-wise, like, you know, you're not in school, say you don't got a business, like, you know, you don't got your life together, you know, you're not working. Those are things that are gonna work against you. If you have all those boxes checked, you're most likely gonna be in a good standing with a good man. But if some way you don't look good, you don't know how to dress, and you're dressed like a whore, I hate to say it, but you're going to be subjected to a man that's gonna treat you like trash. Men treat you the way you treat yourself, and it sounds so fucked up, but it's really true. And this is why I always say, never ever date while you're insecure. Everyone has insecurities, but if you're wholeheartedly insecure, you have no business in the dating world, because they're gonna chew you up. You're literally gonna go out there, you're gonna find abusive men, you're gonna find narcissistic men, you're gonna find selfish men, you're gonna find the worst men that you never even thought existed out there.
Dressing modestly is such a feminine thing to do because it accentuates your figure instead of revealing it. And here's the thing, you can dress modestly and beautifully. There are so many examples of this. Look at Kate Middleton, Michelle Obama, and Ivanka Trump. Nobody looks at them and thinks, wow, they're frumpy. But in today's day and age, where everything goes, it's hard to know what's modest and what's not. Women like J.Lo and Shakira dancing in sparkly leotards and being praised for their bodies doesn't really help either. Because at 50 years old, do you want to be trying to be praised for your body or praised for your family, for your body, or for your wisdom? Treating your sexiness like it's your best feature is a losing battle, because time always wins. And now you're competing with other women too.
And she's trying to say you can't be 50 and sexy. Bitch, I'm trying to be 50 and sexy. What are you talking about? I hate to be an asshole, but I'm black and black don't crack. I think I'm gonna look like this when I'm 50. I hope so. Someone screen record this and send this to me when I'm 50. I hope I still look like this.
Beauty is both inside and out. It's about how your soul shines through your eyes and through your smile. It's about how your external features complement your personality. Sexiness is just about your body. Modesty reminds us what's important. Of course, it's amazing to keep in shape. It's amazing to work out and stay fit. But what? I hope that when I'm 50, people are talking about my accomplishments as a mother, as a wife, and as a woman with values, not my muscle tone.
The fuck is she talking about? What the fuck does that have to do with me dressing modestly? Like, oh my God. Okay, I guess the point here is you want to be praised for you as you, not for what you have on. And when you're dressing like a slut all the time, I don't know why I'm using these words, I'm so sorry. I just can't take this video serious. When you're not dressing modestly all the time, people are directly paying attention to what you have on. They're paying attention to your sex appeal. They're paying attention to your body. Not you as a person, not your accomplishments, not your family, blah, blah, blah. But I feel like this is directly attached to the fact that women have to be moms, women have to be caregivers, women have to, you know, take care of the household and achieve all these things. Women have other things to do. How about if I don't want to be a mom? How about if I don't want to be a wife? How about if that's not a woman's goal? I want to do these things, but how about if a lot of women don't? Like, so what's the advice for them, huh? Huh, genius? What's the advice for that? Like, I don't understand. Like, why is it that when it comes to modesty culture, that's the only choice y'all have for women? Why can't women do other things? Like, how about if I want to be an astronaut? I don't think astronauts have that much time to themselves. How about if I want to be a stripper? How about that? How about that's what I want to do? How about I want to be a stripper?
So what does modesty really mean?
Yes.
It means not wearing something that shows off every curve and crevice of your body when it might be better off left in the bedroom. It means not wearing something that could easily be mistaken for lingerie. It means not wearing something you'd be embarrassed to see your family in. I get the pull toward wanting to dress immodestly, and I'm not criticizing anyone for it.
I'm sorry, that was way too vague. I don't understand, because to be honest, if that's the case, so if I wear a turtleneck dress that's kind of like tight, but like down to my knees, that's skin tight and that can show all my curves. Is that considered modest or immodest? Because I remember there was a situation where there was a gospel singer, I completely forgot what her name was, and people were dragging her because they were saying that was immodest, but her body was covered, her curves were showing, but I didn't think there was anything wrong with the dress. So it's like, is being modest a subjective situation or not? Like, I don't know, because at this point, it's like, what you're telling me is modest, a lot of people consider not modest, so...
So ladies, let's be classic, and let's dress like the ladies we are. I'm hoping to do some more videos on how to dress modestly and fashionably.
Please don't.
What the difference is between beauty and sexiness, and why making everything about sexiness isn't good for society as a whole.
That video was very cringe and very problematic, mainly because, of course, like I said, it's only geared towards girls and women. Second, because it genuinely was too vague, like what is modest and what's not modest. Something can literally hide everything but still technically not be modest. And then on top of that, why is this only pertaining to having to show your body for the opposite sex's attention? And in this terms, we're talking about women trying to show off their body for men. Like, I feel like there's definitely a pressure for women to do things for society, and a lot of women do things for men's attention. But in this case, when it comes to clothes, I feel like a lot of women wear certain clothes for personal expression. Like, I love to get dressed, okay? If you guys follow me on Instagram, you would know, like, I be flea. Like, listen, even when I'm in the house, bruh, like, I legit will literally get the cutest little house set, literally just be cute on my little couch playing my little games. Like, who's watching me? I don't know. The Lord, the Loa, the devil, somebody. But I'll be cute in my house to go nowhere. I've always worn heels. I've always got dressed. I don't wear makeup and stuff, but like, I have friends that wear makeup on a very regular basis. I have friends that also get dressed regularly, and it's not for male attention. It's because it makes them feel good. It makes them feel alive. It makes them feel more awake. It makes them want to actually do things. It makes them want to be proactive. I do believe sometimes it does get toxic, and it does get to the point where it is attention getting, and I have talked about that numerous times. When it gets to the point where it's like you can't leave the house without wearing booty shorts or without wearing a wig or without wearing makeup, it does get toxic. That's a problem. You need to get that checked out. But if that's not the case, I really don't think it's that big of a deal. With that being said, comment down below, because I really want to hear, what is the modesty for men? Because I don't see it. Also, what did you think about this video? Did you think it was toxic? Do you think it was positive? I don't know. Am I reaching? Are other people reaching? Because a lot of people have made reactions about this. I might just link some down below. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm going to see y'all next time. Bye!